I request our honorable guest of honor, C. Yunus, who is the founder of the Grameen Bank in Bangladesh, request to come on to the dais, please. The dignitaries, the celebrities on the dais, who are kind enough to accept our invitation to participate in the next Women's Parliament and have come over here. The distinguished guests, friends from media, the participants, delegates of this conference, young girls, young women all the way, they have come to participate here. I am very, very thankful to you. I invite you all. Good morning to everybody. I am very much privileged and I am so happy to participate and host, to organize this National Women's Parliament Conference for 3 days in the sunrise state of Andhra Pradesh in front of River Krishnamma in such a big way. The population, 50% are women, but they are facing so many problems, hurdles to survive, to grow, to prosper, to contribute to the growth of the family, society and nation. So we are conducting in this direction the first National Women's Parliament in our country. It is going to be a historical event for all. I am glad that this first National Women's Parliament is being held in Andhra Pradesh government, also Andhra Pradesh State Legislative Assembly, with the cooperation of Maharashtra Institute of Technology, Pune. Women's empowerment is not a new concept. It has long been in our vision and practice. The only limitation is that we could not achieve it because we are not paying much attention. We are not able to achieve to the level of our desired expectations so far. To make further study strides, we also should be committed together to accord all women a better place of appreciation and dignity. I am sure that day comes in the nearest future. To initiate this, India is a great, great country which has given voting right to women decades ago. When every country has not thought of giving this voting right to women, India thought of it. So we are proud of our constitution, and the Dr. Ambedkar, who has written our constitution, which provides voting right to the women. Also Andhra Pradesh, before any other state take up, we have provided our women a right in the parental properties. Also, we have started Mahila Vishwavidyalay for the women education empowerment. Also, this state has provided 33% of opportunities reservation in education, in employment. Also, 50% of local body opportunities are reserved for our women. The women's empowerment is a continuous process and it is not a one-time activity. Women's empowerment is a consolidation of their effective self-concept, self-confidence, proactive attitude, decision-making ability, determined execution, accountability to accept the outcomes and readiness for their future strides. Our keen insights into the achievements of great women leaders will prove that they were the icons of the leadership with all these qualities. Life was never a bed of roses for them. They accepted all their limitations in the first place and then they started growing and going beyond them to establish their own impressions. Many dignitaries here on the dais have risen to the heights after facing so many hurdles. The very objective of this next women's parliament is to breathe life into the youthful idealism of all women, students and girls, and make them realize that they are the creators of their own destiny, and to prove their very fact that there are many guest leaders on this platform, as I said, of 3 years to enlighten all of us with their personal experiences, thoughtful visions and exemplary guidance. What all we require is open-mindedness to accept the realities with proactive visions. Of course, women have been dependent for long on men and other supporters for change in their lives. But those days have become history today. Women have long started to acquire independence with their change vision. Girls are the toppers in academics today. They are being offered managerial positions even in the multinational organizations. Women are acquiring command over technology, and they are entering into many domains like research, defense, satellite designing, and so on, which were thought of to be men's domain so far. The gender is only a biological entity. It does not impose any limitations on women's performance and achievement. The days are not far away when we see unconditional independence between and among men and women in their social life. Excellence is everyone's right. Ours is a nation wherein values and culture form a sound base for our progressive ideology. Women's focus should be more on enrichment of personal effectiveness, values and exemplary culture. The future is surely is of women with their leadership, vision. Optimism takes our thoughts to the horizons of higher order. Women should not spend much time on thinking of why things could not be proper for them all these days. Instead, they should start seeing the issues through the lens of solutions and amendments. That vision should make them exemplary leaders. ఈ విధంగా ఒక పక్షి ఎగరాలంటే ఒక రెక్క చాలదు, ఒక వ్యక్తి ఒక మనిషి నడవాలంటే ఒక కాలు చాలదు. నవ్ ఇస్ అవర్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ. కుటుంబాలు కానీ, సమాజం కానీ, ప్రభుత్వాలు కానీ ఎగిరే పక్షికి బలమైన రెక్కవ్వాలి, నడిచే వ్యక్తికి రెండో కాలివ్వాలి. అప్పుడే ఈ సమాజం సమగ్రమైనటువంటి అభివృద్ధి చెందుతుంది. ఆ యొక్క ప్రవాహ నమ్మకంతోనే ఇవాళ నేషనల్ ఉమెన్స్ పార్లమెంట్ ని కాన్ఫరెన్స్ ఏర్పాటు చేశాం. వచ్చినటువంటి నా చిన్నారులు, ఆడబిడ్డలు అందరూ కూడా 3 రోజులు మహామహులు అందరూ వచ్చారు. రేపు ఎల్లుండి కూడా రాబోతున్నారు. వాళ్ళు చెప్పే సందేశాలు, అనుభవాలు విన్న తర్వాత జీవితంలో ఒక నమ్మకం, ఒక విశ్వాసం, ఆత్మగౌరవం కలిగి మీరందరూ ఇళ్ళకి వెళ్ళాలని కోరుకుంటున్నాను. ఆ దిశగా చేసినటువంటి ఈ చిరు ప్రయత్నానికి సహకరించినటువంటి ప్రభుత్వం కావచ్చు, సమాజం కావచ్చు, పాత్రికే లోకం కావచ్చు, విద్యార్థులు కావచ్చు, విద్యా సంస్థలు కావచ్చు, అందరికీ ఒకసారి ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేసుకుంటూ నాకు అవకాశం ఇచ్చిన ధన్యవాదాలు. అందరికీ నమస్కారం.
Thank you very much, sir. A big round of applause for Dr. Kodela Siva Prasada Rao ji.